Today in Qain's World, we're going to do an introduction to OpenWRT, and we're going to install it onto a 1900ACS router from Linksys. Some basic topics of installation of OpenWRT onto the 1900ACS, setting up the Wi-Fi, and then we're going to touch on a slightly more advanced topic of connecting one 1900ACS router to another router, whether it be another 1900ACS, a 1200, a 3200, a Netgear, D-Link. As long as it's got the WDS functionality enabled, that's what we're going to cover. There is a possibility that you can connect these to non-WDS enabled routers, but we'll cover that in a later video. The idea is to extend your wired network over Wi-Fi to another segment of a wired network. So you have many wired devices here, many wired devices here, link them up over Wi-Fi. Using the AC radio in the 5 gigahertz band, we're able to connect to these routers with a greater than 1 gigabit speed, which means any single device isn't going to saturate your wireless uplink. The first thing that we're going to do is we're going to obtain OpenWRT. Let's go to openwrt.org and we will find the version that we need for the 1900ACS. You can browse around and find the appropriate version for your device. But since we got the 1900ACS, we're going to go here. As of this recording, we're going to download the Chaos Calmer 5.05. You can download the original and then update the 5 gigahertz driver, or you can just download this version here, straight from the lead developer for OpenWRT, who's added the updated driver for the 5 gigahertz radio. Installation is really simple. It used to be we had to go through this crazy process, but now it literally is as easy as going to the update firmware and that's it. It's going to yell at you and say, hey, I don't recognize this. You say, yes, you do. And then you say, yes, again. And then it's it. And it'll reboot and it'll come back up. Once it reboots and you are able to log back into the router, we're going to log in, click this link, and we're going to assign it a password. Enter your password. And then the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna set up the wireless radios. So click on Network, Wi-Fi. We're going to go ahead and set up the 5 gigahertz radio first. Go to security, set up the security code. I like to force it to be AES. I'm going to save that. And we'll go ahead and set up the other one for the 2.4 gigahertz radio. This is basically the N radio that would be for anything legacy. It gets speeds up to about 600 megabits a second. The 5 gigahertz on the AC can get you 1300 megabits a second. This one gets you 600, hence the 1900ACS. This concludes the basic configuration of your OpenWRT enabled router. Next, I'm going to show you how to extend your wired network over your wireless to another wired network. So we're going to have one set up as a WDS access point and then another set up as a WDS client. Let's start by adjusting the primary and setting up the WDS access point. It's just as simple as going into the configuration for the Wi-Fi on the 5 gigahertz radio, selecting access point, scrolling down to access point WDS, and then saving and applying. Everybody else is still going to be able to connect to it like normal, but it enables the WDS capabilities. Now we're going to log into our new router, install OpenWRT. To configure the new router, it's basically the same as the old one. We're going to log in, set a password, but when we go to set up the wireless, we're instead of selecting access point, we're going to select client WDS. And then we're going to hit save. We're not going to hit save and apply, because we're going to go over to the local network. We're going to assign it a static IP of 192.168.0.254 or .254 on your network. And then we're going to disable DHCP because it's going to get DHCP from the other end of the wireless network. And you're going to hit save and apply. If you've done everything correct and you're wired into the secondary router, you should be able to plug in your machine, get an IP address, and then access the internet as you would if you were connected to the primary. I hope you found this video helpful. You can always like, subscribe, and comment down below. And stay tuned, and we look forward to more videos where I'm going to be talking about OpenWRT and delve a little bit deeper into some of the functionality with some QoS and most definitely the asterisk voice over IP PBX. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.